Thank you. My name is Craig. I've known John for many years. He hasn't introduced me. He's a great person to know, with an outstanding sense of humor. I had an opportunity to work with him on various projects of radio, and as a friend, he couldn't be a better person. I always enjoyed being with John. There was never a dull moment, and of course, between John and Kevin, you never can be a dull moment. You mischievous guy. So, yeah, I was so honored to know him. And he brought a lot of joy to me, and enjoyed, you know, being part of his life. And thank goodness I had an opportunity. So, thank you, and I'm glad you all came.
Thanks, Greg.
I remember how John and I first really met. John and I kind of talked casually a little bit in junior high, 7th or 8th grade, I can't quite remember which. But at one point in time, I came to school, it must have been in winter, I was wearing this new white cardigan sweater. And John had convinced a mutual friend of ours, Mark Kramer, to take some chocolate pudding and dump it on my sweater. And I realized that this was not something that Mark would do. Mark was strange, but it wasn't something he would do. And I had seen him talking with John just before that. So I did the math, and I figured, John's as Machiavellian as I am. So I chased John down, got the rest of the chocolate pudding onto his clothing, and we were friends right after that, and ever since. And I've always looked at John as being my brother from another mother. And I remember spending many a Christmas there, and as many a time at John's place that I spent that I don't remember, because we were pretty wasted that decade. But we had some wonderful times together. Patty, of course, you know, she and I as co-workers. After talking with her for a while, just something clicked for me, and I realized, I think John and Patty would get along pretty well. And I was a little more right than I thought at the time. After that, most people started calling me Yenta the Matchmaker, but, you know, it is what it is. But a lot of very fond memories of John, many of which, again, I really can't share on anything that might turn into public media, except for the reason of someone going beyond the statute of limitations. But, you know, we certainly had some great times driving into high school, stopping at Burger King, getting a big golf glass with some ice, not this much 7-Up in it, then filling it the rest of the way with wine, to go off and play some golf with wine coolers, smoke a joint and have a cigarette. And it was downhill for us after that. But nonetheless, we kind of fought with each other through much of school. John branched off in his career with Kiss FM. I kind of tagged along a little bit on his coattails with that. And while he was producing Bruce's show, I was doing music research there, which basically meant answering the phones. But it was something at least to feed to the kids at the Columbia School of Broadcasting. Yeah, we were both working for a little extra cash because radio can pay crap unless you're at the top. And neither of us really quite got to the top there, although John kept trying to pursue. And you know, certainly did continue to get bits and pieces of the voiceover work. And of course, you know, kept his life going with Patty. Sadly, over the years, John began to pull back quite a bit for most of us. And in retrospect, I really think it's because he realized just how ill he was, and being the proud person he always was, didn't want to burden anyone else with that. He always wanted to keep things very close to the vest. He always played it close to the vest. And this was one more time where he just played it a little too fucking close to the vest. And as a consequence, he didn't let us be there when he really needed us the most. But John, I still love you, brother. And wherever you're at, if you're at anywhere, I hope it's okay.
I miss you, Trapper John.
Yeah. Bandit.